Welcome to 7's Assembly. 2 weeks ago, Ms. Kay set our form a challenge to raise awareness of dyslexia around Dover Court School. We decided that the best way to do this was split up and create many different ways to explain to everyone what dyslexia is and how it affects people. We really hope that you enjoy our assembly and by the end of it, understand more about dyslexia. So, Edia, what is dyslexia?
Dyslexia is a difficulty in interpreting words or reading. It does not affect someone's intelligence. Here's a video to explain it a little better.
How was that? Frustrating? Slow? What were those sentences about? They're actually a simulation of the experience of dyslexia, designed to make you decode each word. Those with dyslexia experience that laborious pace every time they read. When most people think of dyslexia, they think of seeing letters and words backwards, like seeing B as D and vice versa, or they might think people with dyslexia see saw as was. The truth is, people with dyslexia see things the same way as everyone else. Dyslexia is caused by a phonological processing problem, meaning people affected by it have trouble not with seeing language, but with manipulating it. For example, if you heard the word cat and then someone asked you remove the C, what word would you have left? At. This can be difficult for those with dyslexia. Given a word in isolation like fantastic, students with dyslexia need to break the word into parts to read it. Fantastic. Time spent decoding makes it hard to keep up with peers and gain sufficient comprehension. Spelling words phonetically like S-T-I-K for stick and F-R-E-N-S for friends is also common. These difficulties are more widespread and varied than commonly imagined. Dyslexia affects up to 1 in 5 people. It occurs on a continuum. One person might have mild dyslexia, while the next person has a profound case of it. Dyslexia also runs in families. It's common to see one family member who has trouble spelling, while another family member has severe difficulty decoding even one-syllable words like catch.
Why don't we play a little game to understand how frustrating it might be to have dyslexia? You have to say the color and not the word. B-L-I-A.
Dyslexia is also dyslexic. Let's have a look why. Dyslexic people's brains are wired differently, meaning they approach things differently. This can give different gifts such as inventive thinking, solving problems, creativity, good communication, good imagination, curiosity. Our goal was to make a video of famous people who are dyslexic.
Put your hand up if you see anyone that you know.
problems the same way other kids do. In school, unfortunately, they are sometimes returned as lazy, unmotivated, rude, or even stupid. They aren't. Making us dyslexic is my way of honoring the potential of all kids I've known in these communities. It is not a bad thing to be given. Sometimes it's a matter of being very, very talented.
This is Steven's book, and this is what he said about dyslexia. It is more common than you think. You are not alone, and while you will have this the rest of your life, you can dart between the rainbow to get where you want to go, and it will not hold you back.
We decided to respond to Ms. K's challenge by creating a poster, which you will be able to see in the art studio window. On our poster, you can see a few famous people who have dyslexia, people such as Jamie Oliver, Tom Cruise, Leonardo da Vinci, Einstein, and Steve Jobs.
We have also written a bit about what they do as a job. Although they might not be good at school in general, they have talents in other areas, such as drama, cooking, painting, and inventing. Tom Cruise is an award-winning actor. Steve Jobs is the creator of Apple. Einstein invented the theory of relativity. Leonardo da Vinci painted the Mona Lisa, and Jamie Oliver is a famous chef who knew. Some of you might remember a video that our friend Ella made. Ella was a dyslexic girl who used to come here that we knew from year 4. Even though she may have struggled with the school curriculum, she was still really amazing at other things, such as swimming and drawing. Ella had a lot of friends, such as Ida. Her mind would work in a different way, but she would always come up with good ideas. Last night, we received an email from Ella saying,
"Dyslexia, isn't that a disease? Why do people even want to hang out with you?" The hurtful words echoed inside of my confused head. Each time I heard them, I sank deeper and deeper into my own black hole of pure despair. She had been my best friend, a white dove who brought me to peace, until she flew away. And all that kindness and warmth was something darker and frightening. She was a bully, a monster. She had once stolen my heart, and now all of a sudden thrown into a deep, dark well of sorrow, and it is shattered in a thousand pieces. She had given me a painful heartache. I was a victim of bullying. Only because I had a different way of learning. In the corner of my eye, I noticed a big bright poster outside the girls' bathroom. The poster presented that it was Dyslexia Awareness Week. I stood a while staring intensely at it and felt kind of special because there was a whole week when people became aware of dyslexia and learned about it. This was important to me, to everyone with dyslexia. My thoughts were suddenly interrupted by a familiar voice. With the gorgeous red-haired Ida. My rescuer had pulled me up from the black hole in despair, a white dove who had come and never left and never will. For late she laughed, I smiled. We're always late for everything. My best friend grabbed my hand tight and started running faster through the hole for assembly. When we arrived, Mr. Rinaldi, for us kids now King Rinaldi, a hilarious year 6 teacher, got us seated. Mr. Rinaldi was my average teacher. He was easy to talk to, inspiring, he understood me. He cared for everyone in class, he made us laugh. The list can go on forever. I have some of my most wonderful memories of 6IR. It's people like me and Mr. Rinaldi who needs that this world needs tomorrow. Dyslexia Awareness Week was brought up in assembly. A competition was announced, whoever could make the best poster or video about dyslexia again. I rushed home and told my parents that I was determined to win. With the help of my amazing funny little brother Edward, I made a video. I took a couple hours to make it, but it was worth it. The day of the win is to be announced. Ms. Kaitlin came up and asked if they could show my video in assembly. My video in front of the whole school. At assembly, Mr. Rinaldi gave me his keys to fiddle with. I was nervous in general, just a fidgety person. My heart started beating faster when I heard the judges announce the winners. One guy had written, "If life was melons, you might be dyslexic." I didn't really understand that, but somehow the words gave me a cheerful vibe. Then I heard my name through the microphone and felt the eyes of the students and teachers. However, I saw Ian and Mr. Nardi's wonderful, encouraging smiles. From the speaker, I heard my own voice saying it's I heard my voice saying it's okay to be, it's okay to have a different style of learning. At the end of the video, I stood up and smiled with my head held up high, and I walked gently to the judges and told myself I did it. The prize was a bookstore voucher, but the real prize with me was I later found out that students with parents who watched my video finally understood why school was so difficult. My eyes filled up with tears of joy. I helped inspire someone. It meant the world for me. I've never found out who the student was, but I know that no matter how tough school gets, he or she will become successful in whatever their dream is. Just like me, that student will never give up. My dyslexic father is now super successful in our field. He reminded me that dyslexia is not a disease, man. It's a gift with dyslexia. Think differently. We can solve problems easier, and we are said to be more creative. There is no reason for any of us to be bullied, to get bullied. Whenever life gets tough for me, I try not to give up and keep chasing my dreams.
Quick facts about dyslexia. Dyslexia is the most common learning disability. Individuals with this medical condition have difficulty in the area of language processing. 1 in 5 people suffer from dyslexia. About 70-85% of children who are placed in special education for learning disabilities are dyslexic.
People with dyslexia are usually more creative and higher level of intelligence. Those with dyslexia use the right side of the brain to process language, while non-dyslexics have 3 areas in the left side of the brain to process language.
Children have a 50% chance of having dyslexia if one parent has it, and a 100% chance if both parents have it.
Dyslexia ranges from mild to severe. Around 40% of people with dyslexia also have ADHD, and those with dyslexia use about 5 times more energy to complete mental tasks.
Our group worked together to address the dyslexia challenge and have created a website not only to inform people about dyslexia in school but also worldwide.
Our website has lots of information about dyslexia, such as explaining dyslexia is a learning disability that affects how children read or stop. Only 10% of the population are dyslexic and 4% severely so.
We found out that dyslexia is a neurological disorder that interferes with the processing of language and spelling.
There are tons of people who are dyslexic who become successful. Some more examples are Lee Kuan Yew Swoh, Singapore's first Prime Minister, and girls, forget Albert Einstein, Ivar Kampai is dyslexic, and he was the founder of IKEA. And let's face it, where would we be without IKEA?
If you would like to find out some more information about dyslexia and the effect it has on people, please visit our website. We'll prepare QR codes, which you'll find around the school, to make it easy and quick to visit our website. We will also put the address underneath.
We would like to thank you for listening to our sermon today and hope that you have learned a lot. We would like to leave you with a following message.